Animal groups vary in their collective order or state, from disordered swarms to highly polarized groups. The swarm of midges is an example of extreme group disorder, where individuals are highly unsynchronized in their direction of movement. By contrast, these starling murmurations are an example of collective order, with individuals in the group synchronizing their movements. As well as differences between species in the level of collective order can also fluctuate in the same group of individuals over time. However, the reasons why are poorly understood. To better understand the advantages or disadvantages for individuals in groups, we investigated the role of collective order in the foraging performance of three-spined sticklebacks. In our study, 12 groups of 8 individuals were repeatedly tasked with detecting and reaching a standardized visual stimulus that mimicked a food resource. We tested whether the speed that individuals responded to and reached the resource was different when groups adopted different levels of collective order. The responses of individuals to the stimulus were tracked in high temporal and spatial resolution. We found that certain individuals in the groups were consistently responding first to the stimulus. These individuals were more reliant on their own private information and reached the resource faster when the group was disordered. In contrast, other individuals in the group, the non-first responders, reached the resource faster when the group was ordered, with shoal members swimming in the same direction. The differing effects of collective order on the performance of individuals could be explained by the different visual properties of ordered and disordered groups. In this video, the approximated binocular visual fields of individuals in a group are highlighted in blue. When groups are disordered, individuals' visual fields collectively cover more of their environment, providing improved access to private information. When groups are ordered, by contrast, the visual fields of individuals in the group overlap more, facilitating access to social information. Intriguingly, we found evidence that individuals behaved in a way that was most beneficial to themselves, with individuals that benefited from group disorder tending to be less aligned with their neighbours. Inherent conflict between individuals for their preferred level of organisation in the group may provide a functional explanation for the variation we observe in a group's collective order.